nor those who have been passing through this area during so many centuries. Ghani Khan is a 20th century poet. He says, the Pathans have no written history, but they have thousands of runes where the gods don't tell their story to anyone who would care to listen. And Pashto is the language of such kind of people and code of conduct as well. These people reside in the mountains which is called Rohistan, and knowledge about them is now has been termed as Rohology. Rohology is the knowledge of Pashtuns and their culture. Roh is an ancient name of their land. It is a geographic unit, a territory between the two mighty rivers, Amudarya and Indus of Central and South Asia. This mass of land is mainly plateau or high mountains and politically divided into Afghanistan and western provinces of Pakistan. This whole area has distinct geological, geographical, anthropological, archaeological, historical, linguistic, social, cultural, and religious environment. Its flora and fauna and its climatic region have their unique and specific distinction and are the cradle of some of the most ancient human civilization. Though the name of the area is popularly known as Pashtunkhwa, which means the side of the Pashtuns, but historically known by its ancient Sanskrit name as Rohatyagiri. Rohatyagiri is a Sanskrit word which was in later period abbreviated to Roh. Hence Rohology means the study and knowledge of Roh. The term Rohology has been derived from the two well-known fields of study like Sinology, Egyptology, North Indiology, likewise. Regarding geographic location, the Pashtun abode, the mountains and high plateaus, which had been mentioned some 2 years ago by 200 years, Hafiz Ahmad Khan was the ruler of India in his book. All the abodes of the Pashtuns are situated between Iran, Turan and Hind and Sindh. So their eastern limit is Kashmir and the western one is the Helmand River, which flows near Herat. Between these two countries, there is a distance of about 2.5 months. In those days, distance would be measured by time. Its northern limit is Kashmir, Chitra, and southern limit is the area of Bakhar of Balochistan. All the land situation in between these two. Anyway, the inhabitants of this Roh, when established their colonies in India, they gave it the name of Rohelkhand. These Rohelas or Afghans or Pashtuns are the people who live in the most significant piece of land on the earth due to its strategic importance. Several Arabs thought that though the land was created for the people, though the land was created for the people of Roh, but the people of the soil were not for the land. That means that whenever they got the opportunity, they migrated from it and got settled in some other place. He also thought that the land was such a ramper on the map of Asia that the plateau of Iran is in its west and the heights of Tirichmir and Chitral are in its north. There are those passes in this ramper through which the invaders of Central Asia passed to India, making it the battlefield. History also tells us that the invaders conquered India with the help and support of brave people of the land of Roh and established their kingdoms of their own. Before we look into the higher and positive values of Pashtun, let us talk about Pashtun and Pashtun Bali for a while, which are other names for Pashtun culture. The climate and geographical condition which have played a role in shaping Pashtun culture lies upon 60 degree to 73 degree longitude and 26 degree to 36 degree latitude of the earth. As mentioned earlier, this region is divided into different geographical configurations and areas. Pashtuns live on both sides of different lines. Different tribes live in the north and west of Pakistan and eastern region of Afghanistan, In addition, many scattered tribes live in tribal pockets of northeastern Pakistan as well. In far-flung northwest of Afghanistan, and in some of the southwestern regions, we also find some Pashtun tribes. Also, in the Indian state of Rampur and Rohilkhand, we find sizable Pashtun population. Geographically, the present Pashtun area is surrounded by Karakoram Range in the northeast. In the north and northwest is the Hindu Kush Ranges. In the extreme west and south, there are mostly uninhabited and desert. In the east, we find the lofty peaks of Himalaya. The historic Oxus River flows in the north. River Indus is in the east, Helmand and Hariputra in the south. This is the land of the Pashtun. Like the people, this land of Pashtun is also multicolored. The severe heat of valleys and plains, the alpine cold of the hills, mountains, and extreme weather of the deserts have contributed toward making the people extremists. All this has brought them closer to nature as well. Perhaps it was for them that the great poet Iqbal said, he says, "The higher objectives of nature are protected in the activities of desert dwellers or men living in the mountains." South and north of the Pashtun area are also referred to as upper and lower Lur or Bur Pashtunkhwa. Lur means Pashtunkhwa in Pakistan and Bur is the Pashtunkhwa of Afghanistan. Bajor, Khyber, Tochi, Kuram, Gomal and Bulan are the famous passes which connect the Pashtun living on both sides of the river Nile. In history, this region is referred to as Rohistan, Yagistan, Afghana, and Pashtunkhwa. About the significance of this region and the people in Asia, Iqbal, he says, and it's a proof of today, that Asia is a structure of a clear water. The Afghan nation is like the heart of this structure. The disruption of Afghan is the disruption of Asia, while the liberty of Afghan means liberation of Asia. It's in this kind of background that Pashtun culture has emerged. This culture is poor but self-respecting, and it is known for its toughness and religiosity. As this makes for a conservative social system, Pashtun are a frugal people, but on special occasion, they tend to show extreme generosity. They attach great importance to national pride and family honor. Their insistence upon equality and their intense democratic spirit often leads to fight and competition. This way of life and psychology has led some people call Pashtun society as ordered anarchy. Ghani Khan, in his particular style, comment humorously about this nature of Pashtuns.